God, help us to be fully conscious now of your presence with us. Bring our hearts into harmony with your holiness and love. We dedicate this sacred ceremony to you. We especially pray that Greg and Jessica will feel your loving hand laid upon theirs as they exchange their wedding vows, and that you will anoint them with your Holy Spirit as they step together in faith across the threshold into a new life together. We ask these things in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Marriage is most serious that it will bind the two of you together so intimately that the two of you will become one. Before you lies a future full of hopes and disappointments, successes as well as failures, pleasures, pains, joys, and sorrows. And this is just the way life is. All of these things are mingled in throughout life. But please do not receive anything in resignation or in despair, but only in the hope and the love and the joy that God will continuously restore in your life. Greg, do you desire to be united in marriage with Jessica? And will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and be her helper as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will.
I will.
Same with you, Jessica. Do you desire to be united in marriage with Greg? And will you love him, honor him, and be his helper as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Who presents Jessica to be married to Gregory?
Her father. Her mother and I.
Very good.
Just him.
All right, very good. You may be seated.
Love you. Can I give these to my sister?
Sure. The scripture that Jessica and Gregory have chosen for today is out of 1 Corinthians. It's chapter 13. And I'm sure as I read it, you'll have heard some of the words of it, because some of it is popular poem that you might have hanging on your wall or in a kitchen magnet or something. So this is from 1 Corinthians, and it says, "If I speak in the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Many things will pass away. These three things will remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of all these things is love." This scripture can be split up into three easily understood sections. The first one is just about without love, and that's pretty self-explanatory. I think you could think back maybe to your teachers or the people that taught you the things in life, and if they didn't have love, if they didn't do it with love, you didn't learn, you just moved on. So in order to be effective, you have to love, and the scripture says that, in fact, the greatest theologian, the most brilliant teacher, without love teaches nothing. Now, the one thing to remember about this passage is that it's a part of a letter. It's just a little part of a letter that was written by a man named Paul to the people in Corinth. And the reason why it was written is because the people in Corinth were fighting over who was more important and who had the better gifts. So Paul wrote them the letter to basically say, settle down. You know, not one of you is better than the other. And whatever you do, you have to do it with love. So the second part of this scripture is just a really good reminder of what to do when you're having troubles loving. So you remember that sometimes you just have to make love act even though you're not feeling it. So what I want you to do is when you're in the midst of, I don't know if it'll be your first fight or second or third or whatever the case may be, but this is what I challenge you to do, and all of us to do, when you're in the middle of a disagreement. And these are the exact words taken from the scripture. Be patient. Be kind. Don't envy. Do not boast or brag, and don't be all proud of yourself. Please don't be rude to one another or self-seeking. Try not to anger easily, and don't keep track of each other's wrongs. Don't get caught up in evil things that keep you from standing proudly before God and one another. If you can, you will stand tall in the truth. Don't cross boundaries. Don't cross relational boundaries, because once you cross them, they're really hard to get back to where you belong. So protect one another, trust one another, and offer hope to one another. And if you do all these things, then love perseveres. And when love perseveres, that's called permanent love. And that's the last part of this scripture. What you need to do is to do the things that you really enjoy doing with love. For example, I know that, Greg, you like to hunt, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's a pretty sure statement, right? Jessica, name something. Tell me something that you like to do.
Camping.
Me too. So remember to do these things in love, because whenever you're old and gray, and I see it all the time, I work for hospice. I work for people who are at the other end of life spectrum. And they're at the end, and they can't do the hunting, and they can't do the camping and the things that they love anymore. All they have is each other. And I see them sitting together, tears rolling down their face in an empty hospital room or in a room somewhere, and all they have is love, and it's extremely powerful to have just that. So, and we don't need to think about that today. What you need to think about is the joy that you are experiencing. I have a little piece of a letter that I want to read to you, and it was written by a father to her daughter on her wedding day. And he says, young love is a temporary madness. It erupts like an earthquake and then subsides. And when it subsides, you have to make a decision. You have to work out whether your roots have become so entwined together that it is inconceivable that you should ever part. Because this is what love is. It is greater than today's breathlessness, excitement, and promises. You have already begun to grow roots towards one another underground. And when all the pretty blossoms have fallen from your branches, I pray that you will find that you are one tree and not two. This is what you call permanent love. My prayer for you is a long, long life together, full of God's goodness. And I also pray for the courage that you can dream and that your dreams will come true. And in good times and challenging ones, do what this message tells you to do, and that is to have faith in God, offer hope to one another, and of course love, because the greatest of all these things, as I've already said, is love. And now we have a reading. It's called All I Ever Really Needed to Know I Learned in Kindergarten, and this is something that's dear to Jessica's heart, and she would like Jen and Tiff to read it. So they will come up here and read it.
All of what I really need to know about how to live and what to do and how to be, I learned in kindergarten. Wisdom was not at the top of the graduate school mountain, but there in the sandbox at the nursery school. These are the things I learned.
Share everything.
Play fair.
Don't hit people.
Put things back where you found them.
Clean up your own mess.
Don't take things that aren't yours.
Say sorry when you hurt somebody.
And wash your hands before you eat.
Flush.
Warm cookies and cold milk are good for you. Give them to someone who feels sad.
Live a balanced life.
Learn some and think some. And draw, and paint, and sing, and dance, and play, and work every day.
Take a nap every afternoon.
Be aware of wonder.
Everything you need to know is in there somewhere, and it is still true, no matter how old you are, when you go out into the world, it is best to hold hands and stick together.
Thank you. Are you ready for your vows?
Ready.
Ready. Okay. Greg, you can start and you can repeat after me. Jessica, I love you.
Jessica, I love you.
You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
Today, I give myself.
Today, I give myself.
To you in marriage.
To you in marriage.
I promise to encourage.
I promise to encourage.
And inspire you.
And inspire you.
To laugh with you.
To laugh with you.
And to comfort you.
And to comfort you.
In times of sorrow.
In times of sorrow.
And struggle.
And struggle.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
In good times and bad.
In good times and bad.
When life seems easy.
When life seems easy.
And when it seems hard.
And when it seems hard.
When our love is simple.
When our love is simple.
And when it is an effort.
And when it is an effort.
I promise to cherish you.
I promise to cherish you.
And to always hold you.
And to always hold you.
In highest regard.
In highest regard.
These things.
These things.
I give to you today.
I give to you today.
And all the days of my life.
And all the days of my life.
Jessica? Gregory, I love you.
Gregory, I love you.
You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
Today I give myself to you in marriage.
Today I give myself to you in marriage.
I promise to encourage and inspire you.
I promise to encourage and inspire you.
To laugh with you.
To laugh with you.
And to comfort you.
And to comfort you.
In times of sorrow and struggle.
In times of sorrow and struggle.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
When life seems easy.
When life seems easy.
And when it seems hard.
And when it seems hard.
When our love is simple.
When our love is simple.
And when it is an effort.
And when it is an effort.
I promise to cherish you.
I promise to cherish you.
And to always hold you.
And to always hold you.
In highest regard.
In highest regard.
These things I give to you today.
These things I give to you today.
And all the days of our life.
And all the days of our life.
I have the wedding rings, and the wedding rings are an outward and visible sign of an inward and invisible spiritual grace, signifying to all the spiritual uniting of Gregory and Jessica in holy matrimony through the Church of Jesus Christ. Gregory and Jessica, may you, like these rings, always circle back to one another. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, these rings, the giving of these rings also, as they may always remind Jessica and Greg of their love and promises to one another, and of your love and promise to them both. Let the precious metal be a reminder of how precious is the love they share, and let the circle, with no beginning and no end, remind them that their love to one another, like your love to them, is endless. All right, Greg, I'm going to start again. And repeat after me. Jessica, this ring.
Jessica, this ring.
I give to you.
I give to you.
As a token of my love and devotion.
As a token of my love and devotion.
And Jessica. Gregory, this ring I give to you.
Gregory, this ring I give to you.
As a token of my love and devotion to you.
As a token of my love and devotion to you.
Jessica and Gregory have chosen to do a sand ceremony, so we will step back and do that. Therefore, a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh. This is out of Genesis. God created you as an individual, perfect by his glory and love. But God also said that it was not good for man to be alone, and so he created woman to be his partner and helper. Today, as the two of you make the covenant before God to join in marriage, you become one flesh. You have chosen to symbolize that union with this sand ceremony. As these three containers of sand are poured together with white sand representing God as the foundation of your marriage, the separated containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into individual containers, so will your marriage be. First, the white sand will be poured to represent your faith in God as the foundation of who you both are as individuals. Now, Gregory, when you pour some of your sand that represents who you once were as an individual, and Jessica will pour her sand representing yourself as an individual before this union. As you both pour the remaining sand of yours simultaneously, your marriage will become completely joined for all eternity, filled with everlasting love. May God bless your marriage so that you are as inseparable as these grains of sand. Love one another as God loves you. Learn what God's love for you is like and reflect it to one another. Love each other with commitment and unselfishness for the rest of your lives.
Forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted in my way. Marry me, stay in every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will.
By the authority committed unto me as a minister of the Church of Jesus Christ, I declare that Gregory and Jessica are now husband and wife according to the ordinance of God and the laws of the state of Pennsylvania, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, whom therefore God has joined together, let no one put asunder. The two of you have pledged your faith and declared your unity. Congratulations. You may kiss. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you and give you peace. And now, for the first time, I present to you all Mr. and Mrs. Gregory and Jessica Parker.
Wow! I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good.
Heart beats fast, colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? But watching you stare.
No matter If there's mountains
not long ago, I was her number one. She told me so, and she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I hate.
But you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take.
Celebrate good times, come on. It's a celebration. Let's celebrate. We're gonna have a good time tonight. Let's celebrate. It's all right.
I won't tell no lie. All of the people around us, they say, can they be that close? Just let me state for the record, we're giving love.
Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Five hops this time. Right foot, let's stomp. Left foot, let's stomp. Right foot again. Left foot again. Right foot, let's stomp. Left foot, let's stomp. Freeze. Everybody clap your hands. Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all. How low can you go?
The girls are drinking, long necks down, and I wouldn't trade old Leroy or my Chevrolet for your Escalade or your Freak Parade. I'm the only John Wayne left in this town. When I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city, I make a lot of noise, 'cause the girls, they are so pretty.
But that just ain't me. Hey! 'Cause I know, if I take that chance, she swears it gonna leave. But what I do is the way she ride.
Call the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, I'm too hot. And my band bought that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girl, set you hallelujah. Girl, set you hallelujah. 'Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
'Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. 'Cause together, bound to be together. She took my arm. I don't know how it happened. We took the floor and she said, oh, don't you dare look back. Just
rain. But you don't.